Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. So myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. Today I have brought to you a lot of questions that can be of use for your RBI, SEBI and NABARD examination, particularly phase 1 exam. So before moving into the questions, let me inform you that you can download the PDF of this session from the Telegram channel, and the link of our Telegram channel is in description. Okay? So here we have the first question: who heads SEBI's alert committee? So we have 5 options, out of which option A, Madhavi Puri Bhuj, is the right answer. Now what is this committee? First of all, alerts stands for advisory committee for leveraging regulatory and technology solutions. So from the name itself, it is evidently highlighted that the purpose of this committee is to suggest measures to SEBI to leverage its technological solutions, to enhance its capacity in terms of technology so that it can detect the anomalies in the securities market. Anomalies as in unexpected events that are happening in the market or unpleasant events that are there. So in order to judge those events, the causes of those events in quick time, this committee will suggest measures. Also, this committee will suggest SEBI to improve its ongoing technology projects as well as in-house technological system. So these are the purposes of this committee. The total number of members of this committee is 7. Again, do remember that Madhavi Puri Bhuj is the head, who has also been the former whole-time director of SEBI. A member, whole-time member of SEBI, not director. Do remember this thing. Next question is, who heads the IFSCA group to create a framework for transfer of stressed loans from domestic lenders to permitted financial entities in IFSCA? So guys, here the right answer is option E, G, Padmanabhan. Okay, so now IFSCA, International Financial Services Centres Authority, has created this group so that the burgeoning NPAs of the lenders can be shifted to financial entities. Basically, the loans, the stressed loans of the banks will be shifted to the selected entities located in the IFSC, which is in GIFT City in Gandhinagar. Now we all know that the bad loans, the stressed loans of the banks is a headache of the financial system of India, and for that the government has already created a bad bank, which is the sole entity responsible for transfer of these stressed loans from the banks to the bad bank. Okay, so your task is to tell me the head of the bad bank, because I have already told you that fact in video as well as in the Spotlight magazine. So do mention in the comment section below who heads the bad bank of India. Moving further, with which country has India signed the treaty on mutual legal assistance in criminal matters? Here the right answer is Poland. Now this agreement has not been signed recently, it was already signed, but Union Cabinet has given its approval to this treaty between India and Poland. Now what is the basic purpose of this treaty? That is to strengthen and enhance the capacity of each other, of both India and Poland, in terms of handling the criminal matters. So that is the basic idea of this. So it seeks to boost investigation and prosecution of crimes, including crimes related to terrorism, through mutual legal assistance. Okay, by collaborating in the legal sphere, India and Poland will boost each other's capacity to handle the crimes. Next question is, which country hosted the 8th edition of Indian Ocean Dialogue? France, UAE, India, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka. The right answer here is India. Now guys, it is a track 1.5 dialogue. I know that majority of you must have gotten confused here. What is this track 1.5 dialogue? Also, whenever we cover some forums, there is this word. I have come across this टाइप ऑफ वर्ड मेनी अ टाइम्स. सो वट आई हैव डन टूडे इज दैट आई हैव डेल्व्ड इनटू द टाइप ऑफ द डायलॉग्स दैट आर कंडक्टेड बाई द गवर्नमेंट. सो आई हैव शेल्ड आउट थ्री काइंड ऑफ डायलॉग्स, ट्रैक 1, 1.5 एंड ट्रैक 2 डायलॉग्स. नाउ वट आर दीज डायलॉग्स, आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस दैट अ लिटिल लेटर, बट फर्स्ट आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू अबाउट दिस इंडियन ओशन डायलॉग. So it was the 8th edition. The most important part of this news is the theme. That is the post-pandemic Indian Ocean, leveraging digital technologies for health, education, development and trade in IORA member states. Guys, if you go, if you try to memorize it word by word, then I think it is next to impossible for you all to memorize this entire theme, because you also have themes related to many important days, themes related to many important summits, and I can't even count the number of summits that take place nowadays with their numerous themes. So what you can do here is that you can put this entire thing into the context. Like this Indian Ocean Dialogue has been held recently. The 8th edition of this dialogue was there. This dialogue was held between the countries surrounding the Indian Ocean region. Therefore, the Indian Ocean Region Association was in charge of this dialogue. Matlab, it helped India in creating and organizing this 8th edition of this dialogue. Now, what is the matter of concern? What was the matter of discussion? Post-pandemic world, where post-pandemic Indian Ocean, how to use the technology, how to leverage the technology for health, education and development, trade and different spheres. So these were the topics which were discussed by the members who were present at this dialogue. So I hope that in this manner you will be easily able to memorize the entire theme of this dialogue. Moving ahead, so Indian Council for World Affairs and the Indian Ocean Dream Association's secretariat, where is it? This is your question that you are going to tell me in the comment section below. So both of these organizations have collaboratively helped India in organizing it. Okay, the last edition was held in UAE. This is a kind of track 1.5 dialogue. Now before going into the details, let me tell you that the first edition of this Indian Ocean dialogue was also hosted by India, and the 8th, the latest one, is also hosted by India. Now let's go into the track 1.5 dialogue. Now guys, we all know that the governments in this age of globalization, all the governments tend to boost their diplomatic relations. And how do they do that? They conduct meetings with each other. So the bilateral or multilateral diplomatic meetings that are held between the countries are known as tracks. Okay, different diplomatic formats of the meetings are known as tracks. So we have three tracks predominantly, 1, 1.5 and 2. So in the track 1, basically it is the conference or the meeting of the high level members of the nation, or the high level leaders of a nation. Therefore, it is of the most importance among the three that are mentioned here. Then the track 1.5 dialogue, which is a kind of unofficial forum, unofficial meeting, where the government officials along with the non-government officials meet together so that they can strengthen their bond. Now in this kind of dialogue, there is more room for strengthening the bond, more room for cohesion between the countries. Track 2 dialogue is the format in which only the unofficial members, non-governmental officials of a country meet with each other. They discuss their problem, they discuss their ways in which they can strengthen the bilateral relations between their countries, between their businesses or the entity which they are, okay, or the sectors in which those entities are performing. So these are the three types of diplomatic meetings that are conducted. I hope that you have known something, you got to know something new through this effort of mine. Now let's move ahead towards the next question. How many Indian traditions, customs have been listed on the UNESCO representative list of intangible cultural heritage of humanity. So guys, 14 is the right answer. Recently, Durga Puja of Kolkata has been added into this list. With this, the total number of Indian traditions in this list is 14. Now, the list goes on as, first is Kumbh Mela, Navroz, Yog, then the brass and copper craft of utensil making from Thatheras, which is a Hindu Sikh community of Jandiala grew from Punjab. Next is Nat Sankirtana from Manipur, Buddhist chanting Ladakh, Chau dance, which is a form of dance originated from Odisha and prevalent in West Bengal and Jharkhand right now. Kalbelia folk songs and dance from Rajasthan, Muddi Yettu, theater and dance drama from Kerala, Raman, religious festival and ritual theater in Garhwal, Himalaya, Kuttiyattam, the Sanskrit theater in Kerala, Ramlila that takes place across the country, Vedic chanting. So all of these are the Indian intangible cultural heritage heritage practices that are listed in UNESCO's list. Now there would be a question in your mind. Are we supposed to memorize all these 14 items? So guys, my answer here is that if you go through this list 5 to 7 times, I will provide you this entire list in Spotlight magazine also, the monthly magazine of December month. So if you go through this list 4 to 5 times, I hope that majority of the things would be there in your mind. You will be able to retain those names, because nowadays the examiner tend to go into the details of the news. So the examiner might ask you about the total number of intangible cultural heritage sites that are there in this list from India. The current one, that is the Durga Puja, that has been included. Also some of the very prominent that are originating from a place like this. Chau dance originating from Odisha, Muddi Yettu from Kerala. So these kinds of things can be asked from you, and they also make up the static portion of your general awareness, like where is this ritual theatre performed in India. So you should be aware of that. Plus we have its importance in this list also. So if you go through this entire list 5 to 10 times, I hope that you will be able to retain it. Moving on to the next question. Which state has signed an MOU with Food and Agriculture Organization and Indian Council of Agriculture Research on Technical Cooperation Project for strengthening capacities to support farmers to adopt sustainable agriculture food practices? So guys, here the right answer is option A. Andhra Pradesh has signed this MOU with the Food and Agriculture Organization, which is a UN specialized agency, and Indian Council for Agriculture Research. Now, we have read the basic purpose in the question itself, that is to boost the capacity of the farmers, to boost the support for the farmers so that sustainable agri-food practices can be adopted in the state. How are they going to do that? They are going to support the Raithu Bharosa Kendras that are already established in the state. The purpose for establishing these Kendras was to remove the fake seeds that are circulating in the market, fake pesticides, fertilizers. So in order to create awareness among the farmers regarding these centers were established. And through this MOU, FAO and ICAR, both of these organizations are going to boost the capacity of these Kendras so that they can again promote the use of organic products. They can also give support to the farmers for adopting the sustainable agri-food practices. Next question is, recently WhatsApp has launched its pilot program for adopting 500 villages for empowering villages with access to digital payment through payments on WhatsApp. Which two states have been chosen by WhatsApp for the pilot program? The right answer is Karnataka and Maharashtra. Now, the 500 villages are the total number of villages that have been selected from these two states, Karnataka and Maharashtra. the very basic intent behind this pilot project is to teach the villagers how to use the payments on WhatsApp feature, and this will serve two purposes. First is the financial inclusion, because villagers are connected with the digital financial medium. Secondly, digital literacy will also be promoted among the villagers. So these are the twofold purposes that this project will serve. Next, when did the Milan 2022 exercise start? So guys, here it's a typing error. It's the Milan exercise. That's the exact question. So it started in 1995. Now Milan is a multilateral naval exercise hosted by India biennially. Okay, so it occurs once in 2 years. Now, recently 46 countries have been invited by India to participate in the Milan exercise. It is going to take place in February 2022, and the place is Visakhapatnam. Now, the place is very important because prior to this, Port Blair was the location for Milan exercise. It was shifted to Visakhapatnam. Therefore, it is important for you to memorize the place. Visakhapatnam is the location for Milan 2022. This exercise also has a theme. Again, very important point here: camaraderie, cohesion and collaboration. So this is the theme. Now we have discussed everything, I guess. Let's move on to the next question. When was NASA's Parker Solar Probe launched? So guys, here the right answer is 2018. I hope that you must have heard about the probe entering the sun's atmosphere. So this is the first time in the human history that a spacecraft is able to enter the sun's atmosphere. So it has entered at the uppermost layer, which is named as corona. So that's the achievement that it has made, for which it was in the news. So do remember this thing. Now it's time for our GK Factory initiative. So the one student told me to discuss about the Bermuda Triangle. So I have taken up that triangle in this video. I'm going to discuss about Bermuda Triangle in a very crisp manner, so that we can understand what this triangle is all about. Okay, so Bermuda Triangle, first of all, let's know the location of this triangle. So Miami in Florida, this Bermuda and the Puerto Rico island in the Caribbean. So this is the exact location of Bermuda, which is in the shape of a triangle. Now guys, first of all, know this thing that it is approximately 5 lakh square miles area. Okay, so this is a huge area. Now this is not the exact boundary, and you need not to memorize this number, that this is spread across 5 lakh square miles. This is not important for you. It was just to inform you that this is this huge. This area is this huge. Now, many of you must have heard about it prior to this also. There are many movies on this. So what is this exactly? It is very notoriously famous for the accidents that happen here. The aircraft accident, the ship accident. So today I'm going to tell you the reasons behind those accidents. Accident ke baare mein to sabko pata hai, but what are the reasons? Are aliens involved in this, in the accidents that take place in the Bermuda Triangle? Or is there any supernatural interference here? No guys, nothing is like that. Okay, first of all, there are many names of this triangle. The most famous is the Bermuda Triangle because of this Bermuda place. It's an island. It is also known as the Devil's Triangle, the Hoodoo Sea, the Limbo of the Lost. So this is a very aesthetic name that has been given to this Bermuda Triangle. Location I have already highlighted, and area again I have highlighted. No need to memorize an area. Memorize to, I guess, kuch bhi karne ki zarurat nahi hai, because I'm just telling you the interesting facts here. So these are the types of accidents. So let's have a glimpse at the accidents. First of all, Christopher Columbus, when he went out in the 15th century to find the new world, that's the America, he also came across, he also encountered the strange happenings between this Bermuda Triangle. But fortunately, he did not get lost, or no misfortune happened with him. Okay, Next is 1945 US aircraft crash. Basically, the US aircraft disappeared in 1945. Then ships wrecked here. So these are some kinds of, some of the incidents that happen here. The number of ships and the number of aircrafts that are damaged is very huge. Okay, so it's not just one or two aircrafts, one or two ships. There are many ships that have been wrecked or sunk in this Bermuda Triangle. So what are the reasons? Let's quickly have a look at the reason. First of all, the very interesting thing that happened, the very mysterious thing that happened when you enter the Bermuda Triangle is that your compass stops working. What's the reason behind that? So according to scientists, it's the geomagnetic field that forces the compass to stop working. Okay, and because of that, aircrafts and the ships particularly lose their track and they get lost. That's the one reason. Okay, the another reason here for the storms that cause aircrafts disappear is this hexagonal clouds. So these are the hexagonal clouds. Now, first of all, hexagonal clouds are named hexagonal because of their shape. It's a hexagon shape. Okay, these were initially found on the Saturn planet, and these are like the air bombs. The air speed is so high in these clouds that if any aircraft enters in it, then it's done for good. Okay, so for the aircraft's disappearance, this hexagonal cloud is the reason. For the ship's disappearance, one reason is the compass failure, and that is due to the geomagnetic field that is there. So these are, guys, the theories that have been given by the scientists. Majority of the theories are still being worked upon by the scientists and the researchers. Let's have a look at some other reasons for shipwrecks. So one more reason here is the ridges. Now, what are the ridges? I hope that majority of you know what ridges are. So briefly, ridges are the mountains that are created because of volcanic eruption beneath the sea surface, beneath the sea level, or level as in the top surface of the sea, and they are not visible from the above. Okay, so the ships and the sailors are not able to see those ridges, and they get attacked. Their ships get attacked with those ridges. They get basically takra jane se ships get sunk in the Bermuda Triangle. That's another reason. And volcanic eruptions is also another reason. So because of volcanic eruptions, various gases emerge out and they create a loss of density in the Bermuda Triangle region. And because of loss or reduced density, not lost density, it's reduced density, ships sunk. Okay, that's one of the reasons. Now, that was the Bermuda Triangle of the Atlantic Ocean. We have another Bermuda Triangle in the Pacific Ocean, which is near Japan. It is named as Dragon's Triangle. Okay, again, we have another names: Pacific Bermuda Triangle, Devil Sea, Formosa Triangle. So these are the names. Guys, can you tell me that at present, which country is residing on the Formosa Island? Which country is basically completely based on the Formosa Island? Tell me that. It's a very famous country, always in dispute with China. So again, I hope that you have guessed. Majority of you have guessed. Okay, so it is near Japan, and there are again same scientific regions, and it's the Pacific Ring of Fire. So again, volcanic eruptions are there, ridges are there, geomagnetic field is also working here, therefore compasses stop working, hexagonal clouds are also formed here. So these are all the same reasons as of Bermuda Triangle in the Atlantic Ocean. India too has a Bermuda Triangle. So let's have a look at that. Now, our own Bermuda Triangle, our indigenous Bermuda Make in India Triangle is in Odisha. Okay, so this is the location. So guys, the three points which are needed to make the triangle are Amarda Airstrip, Chakulia and Perboda. All of these three locations are in Odisha. Okay, so this is the triangle in Odisha. Here also aircrafts collapse with each other, they collide with each other and accidents happen. Since here no ship is, it's the land, so no ship accident is recorded, but the air accidents have been recorded, particularly during the World War II when US used this land to attack Japan. Now, what are the reasons? The most probable or scientific logical reason that has been cited here for the accidents is the uranium mine in Jharkhand, because we can see that here is the Jharkhand and near this area, okay, this is Jharkhand, uranium mines are there, a lot of uranium is there, and uranium is a radioactive element that cause the instruments to fail, the electronic instruments to fail. Therefore, the instruments of the airplanes, aircrafts failed and they collided with each other, they lost the direction and collided with each other. That's one of the most probable reason that is cited for the Make in India Bermuda Triangle. So that's all about the Bermuda Triangle. I hope that now you know that there is no involvement of aliens, there is no involvement of supernatural elements in the Bermuda Triangle of Pacific, of Atlantic Ocean as well as Pacific Ocean or the Indian subcontinent. It's just the scientific reasons that I have already explained for the phenomenon that takes place. So guys, here this video ends. I hope that you have enjoyed the facts that I have told you. If you have any suggestion regarding video, regarding the GK Factory section, or if you want me to discuss something with you in the GK Factory section, you can give me your name, your suggestions in the comment section. I just forgot the name of the person who gave me the suggestion to discuss Bermuda Triangle. I'm sorry for that. But my thankfulness to him that he gave me this idea to discuss the Bermuda Triangle. And I hope with this, majority of you would have cleared your doubts regarding the Bermuda Triangle. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. Do tell me your comments, your feedback regarding the GK Factory or the video in general. Thank you so much.